Hello, today I'm here with a new video, and this is a tag video made by my friend here on YouTube, Anna Halvarsson. We did a collab video, and then we did a face-off, and she had her channel in Swedish then, but now she's gone over to English, so now everybody can follow her. I will of course leave her channel up here and down in the description. And she did her own tag and tagged me, and I love doing tag videos. So I'm going to do this tag, and this is called What Are Your Makeup Purchase Habits? And this is 13 questions, and I think this is going to be a long video, so I guess we just started, so we doesn't be here for too long. If you're wondering a little bit about this angle, my tripod is like broken, and it doesn't want to, like, you know when you screw the camera in different angles, it doesn't want to be in all angles. Just like want to be in one or two angles, so I have to like do like this to be in the frame. I need to buy a new tripod, that's what I'm trying to say. So we just get started. So I have to check down on my phone because these are long questions, and yes. Question number one. What do you love most to buy for type of makeup? What category? And before it was lipstick, but now it's hands down eyeshadow palettes. I love to buy eyeshadow palettes. I love to try new eyeshadow palettes, and I love to buy eyeshadow palettes. Simple as that. And last year I bought a lot of eyeshadow palettes, and that is one little reason that I am on a year-long low buy, if you didn't know. So I love to buy eyeshadow palettes. It's the biggest category of my makeup purchase. So question number two, why do you love that? And that's because you can do so much with an eyeshadow palette. And eyeshadow palettes often have more than 9 shades. Sometimes it has 24, sometimes it has 12 or 15, or yeah, you know. And you can do so much different things. Like a foundation. If you buy a new foundation, you try it, and then you see what the foundation do. Or like a highlighter, it's the same highlighter every time. If you get what I mean, but with an eyeshadow palette, you can do so much with an eyeshadow palette. And that's why, and it's so fun to play with eye makeup. Base makeup, not that much, but eye makeup. Love it. Question number three is like two questions in one. So 3A, have you ever bought something for the packaging? And I think I haven't. I can be like intrigued by the package, but I have never pulled the trigger only by the packaging. Not what I can remember at least. So I would say never on that one. So question 3B, what was it that made you fall for the packaging, and which product was most likely to apply? Are you dissatisfied with the product itself, even though you only bought it for the packaging? And I have no answer to this because I have never bought anything just for the packaging. Question number four. What is that makes you crave, excited about the product? What are you attracted to? Like to purchase a product? Like the packaging, brand or color? And that is, the brand is important to me, not super important, but the brand has to be cruelty free for me. That's like, I can be how intrigued for a palette, but if it's not cruelty free, I will not buy it. So that's like the main thing. The packaging, I think it has to be like a really shady packaging for me to not buy it if I want the colors in it. And also colors, like the product itself, can make me crave it. An eyeshadow palette, I don't need like a flashy packaging. I can buy it. If I like the color story, I like the color, I probably buy it. I don't care that much about packaging. Packaging is always a plus. It is, but it's not something that makes me to buy it or not to buy it. It's never depending on packaging. Maybe if it is like the Glam Light. Now I don't think Glam Light is cruelty free. I think they sell mink lashes. But their packaging, even though I think the palette looks good or the colors look good, I don't want a taco in my makeup. Amongst my makeup, I don't want a taco. Question number 5. Do you buy certain products to collect or add to your collection when you want everything, though you really know you won't use it? I am so good to talk today. It's only one brand that I like collect, and that is Linda Hallberg. I have all the products except for one. And that's one thing is because I have followed Linda for, I think it's over 10 years, and I want to support her, so I will buy everything they come with, even though it maybe doesn't appeal to me as much as it should appeal to me. I didn't buy the eyeliner because I don't use eyeliners, like liquid eyeliners, but all her other products I have bought, and I don't use them that often, but I still use them. So yeah, Linda Hallberg is the brand that I buy like everything from, even though I maybe don't need it that much, I will buy it. Question number 6. What products have you been most disappointed with that you bought? You can choose the bottom 3. And I have 3 products, and I'm going to show you one of them because the other 2 I have thrown away, I think. I'm not sure. But that was one highlighter palette from Niveen Cosmetics. I think I did a video on it. I should still talk English then. I was not a fan of that highlight palette at all. And I also bought a lipstick from them because I've heard so much good of their lipsticks. And it was like the shittiest lipstick I have ever tried. It was a liquid lipstick and it like dried my lips together. And it looks like it was an awful color and everything. So these 2 things I don't have anymore. I don't know, I have decluttered them a long time ago. I don't know if I throw them away or not, but yeah, like shittiest product ever. And the 3rd one, this is a brand that I love, and I don't think this is a shitty product, but I don't use it that much that I thought I was going to, and that is the Blossom palette by Blush Tribe. I have a lot of Blush Tribe's palette, and this, I don't think this is as good as the other ones. It looks like this. It's a rainbow palette, and I love some of the colors so much. Like the green in this is amazing. This yellow is good. I like this one and this one, but I never picked this up to use it. I've done a face-off with this one. I would never buy it now, but I will still keep it. But it's nothing that I recommend, even though I love Blush Tribe. They have so many more good palettes. And then question number 7. Which products are you most satisfied with that you purchased? You can choose top 3. And I have 3 products, and I'm going to talk about why I choose these 3 products. I like the most products I buy when it comes to eyeshadow palettes, because I either know that I like the brand and the formula, or I watch people that I know have the same preference as me. But so like, it's so hard for me to choose like my top 3 products. It's impossible. So I'm going to talk about 3 products that I hesitated to buy, and it took a while for me to buy them, but I am so glad that I bought them. So the 3 products are, we can start with like the easiest one, the cheapest one, and that is actually a mascara. I hate to say that word in English. I have heard so much good about this, but I was like, how good can it be? It's worth the hype from NYX. I have it on today. I love this. It had to dry up a little bit at first. The first time I was and now I love this. I want to buy this again and again and again. It gives me both volume and length. And it's so freaking good. And it doesn't crumble under my eyes. I love this mascara. This is the best mascara I've ever tried. Love it. So I am so satisfied with this purchase. The other one that I hesitated about is the Moonchild Glow Kit from Anastasia. As you may know, I have the Aurora. Not my favorite, but this one, I love this. And this was a friend of mine, Jenny. She used this a lot and I was like, that looks so good on you. And I was like, should I or should I not? And I was like, I don't like my Aurora, why should I like this? I watched so many YouTube videos about this. And then it was on sale in Sweden. I think this was limited edition. I don't think it's available anymore. And I was like, okay, fuck this shit, I'm going to buy it. And I am so happy that I did. I love this. My favorite shade is this pink heart, and that's also Jenny's favorite shade. But I also love this Lucky Clover. So I am so, so happy that I bought this one. I love it. And then the last thing that I'm so... This is some of my favorites like ever. This is 3-in-1 product, and that is... I'm going to try to hold this up for you. The Kaleidos Makeup Futurism Collection. These are 3 of my absolute favorite palettes ever. I love those so freaking much. I am so happy that I bought them. First I was like seeing some videos about them and I was like, it cannot be that special, but it looked amazing. And then some of my friends here on YouTube, like Annette bought it and Jessica bought it, and I was like, should I also buy it? Am I missing out? So I pulled the trigger, bought them. I love those 3 palettes. They are so, so, so good. So I am so satisfied and happy that I bought the Futurism collection. Question number 8 is also a 2-part question. Is there any special brand you buy everything or almost everything from what they release? And I answered this previously. I buy 99.9% from Linda Hallberg, and that's the only brand I do it from. 8B. Is it just because it is the brand you buy it, or because you like everything from that brand? And I like almost answered this as well. I want to support Linda. I love the products that they do. They are 100% vegan, 100% cruelty-free, 100% multi-use products. I just love that, and it's a Swedish brand, Swedish girl. She is like a normal girl. She has worked so freaking hard for this, and she's really, you can really see that she loves what she's doing. So yeah, it's both that I want to support the brand and I want to support Linda. I'm fangirling over here. Yes. Question number 9. Is there any brand you do not buy from and why? I don't buy from any brands that has done makeup. Other than that, no. I don't buy from Kat Von D anymore. But that's just... like this canceling culture. I don't really know what I think about it, but... after this like all anti-vax thing, she doesn't come out with no more fun stuff anymore. It's like the same old stuff. It's nothing fun. It's no edge. It's no crazy colors. It's no like gothic things like the Satan Singer palette. So I don't buy from Kat Von D anymore. a little bit because of the all the controversy, I just like, I can't, and also because she doesn't come out with any fun things. Other than that, no. I don't buy eyeshadow palettes from Jeffree Star. I use some of his products on camera and off camera, but I'm like neutral. He has amazing lipsticks. They are like some of the best liquid lipsticks ever. They like hold through everything. And he has such fun colors, and they are eye safe, and they are vegan. So yeah. So yeah, I just going to leave it with I don't buy from brands that test on animals. Question number 10. Where do you prefer to buy your makeup? Is there any reseller you highly recommend? And I love Beauty Bay. And I love Kicks. That's, yeah, Swedish. Other than that, no. And I don't have like a secret little shop that I buy from that I can tell you about, because I don't have that. I really don't like Sephora. Okay, a little bit aside the story. Sephora, one thing I hate about Sweden, I don't know if it is like this in any other countries, a brand in Sweden can buy the rights to certain products or certain brands. So, when Sephora came to Sweden, they bought the right for NARS, Too Faced, and Benefit, I think. And then you couldn't buy from like Beauty Bay from NARS to and ship it to Sweden, because Sephora owned the right to sell NARS in Sweden. And Sephora, at the time when they opened, I think they had 3 stores in Sweden, in the 3 biggest towns in Sweden. Or if they had 2 in Stockholm and 1 in Malmö, I don't really know. But and they didn't have a web shop. I hate that about Sephora. And now like Tarte, they own the rights to sell Tarte in Sweden. But I think you can still buy from Tarte in the US. I don't know, but that's one thing I hate. But that was not the question. I was just a little bit angry about it. But I would recommend Beauty Bay or Kicks if you live in Sweden or in the Nordics. Question number 11. Is there any place you would not buy your makeup from? And why? And I wouldn't buy from like a sketch little web shop that I don't do. And I always search for like Makeup Geek. There is some online shops in Sweden that sell Makeup Geek. And then I always go into Makeup Geek and look up their retailers. So I would never buy from like a little sketchy web shop that looks homemade, because then I don't believe it's the real deal. So that I would never do. And also I would not buy from a private person. I would not buy secondhand makeup, used makeup. I don't care if you do. I have sold some used makeup, like makeup I have used like 4 times and I didn't like, I have sold them. But me, myself, I would not buy used makeup. You do you, I do me. Question number 12. What product have you checked in right now that you really want to buy but not have bought? Why didn't you buy it? And what product is it? And I have some products I want to buy, and I'm going to make a video about this. But I can take one thing, and that is the Affinity 2 palette from Certify. I think I have decided to buy it. Or the Oceanic palette from Ace Beauty. I don't know, but I think I want to certify Affinity 2. And the reason why I haven't bought it, first, when it was a pre-order, I wanted to know what people thought about it. So I didn't want to buy it because of my low buy. If I bought it and spent one of my monthly buys on it, and then it was not good, even though I don't know why it wouldn't be good. But I didn't want to do that. I wanted to see some reviews of it and stuff like that. And now I really want to buy it. It's sold out. So that's why I haven't bought it. I'm going to buy it. I think it's coming back now in June sometime. I think there was on their website. So yeah, in the end of this month I would probably have bought it. So just affinity 2 palette. Question number 13. And the last question, finally. I have talked like forever. Is there any product you really want to but have not bought it because of the price? If so, which one? And okay, I don't know how to put this out so I don't sound like a snobby bitch or something. I have never done that. Not bought a product because it's too expensive. And that's not because I have a lot of money. That's mainly because I do not like bougie brands. That's like the only reason. The most bougie brand I like is maybe like Anastasia, and that's not that bougie. Like base products, I like drugstore things. Eyeshadow palettes, I like mostly indie brand, and they are never expensive, and I am also okay to pay a little bit more when it comes to indie brand. So I think I never have not bought a product because I thought the price was too high. And I think I never wanted such an expensive product either. It's like I don't want to test out the Estee Lauder Double Wear, and I think Estee Lauder try the makeup and they are not cruelty free. It's not for me. I like my foundation. I love this one. And this is like 169 Swedish crowns. I don't know how much it's in dollars. Maybe $15. I love it. So yeah, that was the last question and the end of this tag video. And Anna, you did a really fun tag. I have talked a lot. And I really hope you liked this video. And I will of course leave all the questions down in the description. And also Anna's channel. You should really check her out. And yeah. If you have a channel, do this tag. If you don't, chat with me in the comments about this tag video. So yeah. I really hope you liked this video. And I hope I will see you in the next one. Bye.